I never thought I'd say this, but that maggot is adorable.
They're really not. So we're going to replace them with something less gross, but still small, white and wriggly. Puppies! While we don't want to look at the larvae, experts say in the face of the growing landfill liability, a bit of maggot magic could be the answer.
They consume large quantities of really gross things very, very fast.
Australia has a mission to halve the amount of organic waste going to landfill by the end of the decade. Currently, most recycled food waste ends up as high-grade compost or biogas, and there's not much demand for those end products.
The thing we have to start thinking about when we think about waste isn't just a place to put it so it goes away, but we've got to really meaningfully move towards a circular economy. And what maggots help us do is take the lowest value thing and turn it into a really high value thing.
Black soldier fly grubs are capable of converting huge amounts of food waste into animal feed and fertiliser in just 12 days. A regional pilot of this pupa program saving the Albury tip 385 tonnes of food waste in a year.
We'll try anything, even if it is maggots doing all the hard work for us. And from that, a trial began and the results were amazing.
Spiking the interest of other councils, with the City of Sydney now also discussing the merit of maggots.
The average household's garbage bin contains a third of food scraps. We want to keep that out of the red lid bin and turn it into a useful product.
Only about a quarter of councils around the country now offer organic waste collection. So about 7.6 million tonnes of food ends up at the dump every year. There it rots and produces a methane that has 24 times the global warming potential of CO2.
We're always on the lookout for better ways to try and convert these food scraps into the best environmental product ever.
The challenge now? Getting the people behind these loathsome larvae.
Australians love an underdog, and so there's no greater underdog in the Australian story than the maggot. Our maggots are uniquely adorable, I have to say.
They are adorable.
Come on,
look, they're doing amazing things, magical maggots. Look how cute, look, it's like a little walrus.
What
look.
Are those teeth?
Look at that, I mean, don't look at that.
Play-Doh or something.
No.
What is that?
No, that's real.
That maggot has got a maggot on it.
Oh. See? Oh. That's because eventually they can eat themselves because they're just that good at getting rid of waste.
Okay, I'm very happy. I think this is great. Okay. But don't expect me to love them.
Why?
Why? Why do I have to love them? And what happens to them at the end? Don't they all get squashed and killed
and
turned into the pellets?
Yes. Fertiliser, yes.
So don't make me love them and have my heart broken on a scale of several hundred million every 12 days.
Yeah. That's actually.
Do you have this cheese that you can buy that has maggots in it? Well, actually, no, you can't buy it anymore. It's been banned in Europe. But
right,
the maggots,
the
maggots
like...
make it all stinky and tasty, apparently.
Oh, great.
Oh, no, we need the maggots to eat that.